What is going on, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. Hope you're having a great day so far. My name is Maxwell Van. I'm a 17-year-old record producer. And today, yet again, I'm sorry I posted already today. Hopefully you don't mind two uploads in a day. I usually don't do it, but I think we can all make an exception for Taylor Swift. She just released her version of Love Story. There's a bunch of controversy and complications and contractual stuff that warranted her making a different version of the song. I don't know 100% of it. I know a lot of it just from talking to people in the industry and stuff, but that's not what this video is about. This video is about this version, which was released, and I could not wait another second to watch it. I want to react to it live here with you guys. So that's what we're going to do. I'm very excited. It's a lot of nostalgia. It's been 11 years since the original song came out. I literally can't wait. If you guys are new here and if you're a Swiftie, do me a favor, subscribe, leave a like on the video because I'm going to do more because she's about to put out a whole album with some bonus songs we've never heard before. So I cannot wait for that. So make sure you guys subscribe so you know as soon as I post reactions to those. I don't want to wait any longer though. Let's watch and react to Love Story, Taylor's version. Her voice sounds so good. Okay, I don't mean to like fanboy. I do actually, no regrets, but this is exciting. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, let's go. See the light, see the party, the ball gowns, see you make your way through the crowd and say hello. Little did I. I don't mean to keep pausing it, but when she said Juliet, it sounded so good. It sounded better than the original by far. The way she said yes, she was like, yes. It's almost like she started saying the word halfway through the word. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm going crazy. Okay, let's keep going. It's a love story, baby, just say yes. She went, so I sneak out. In the original, she went, so I sneak out. That might not seem like a big deal at all, but it sounds so good. And this version sounds like the way it should sound. You know, I feel like after 11 years, you know, she's putting this out again. Now she has the opportunity to adjust the things that she wanted to adjust. Because a lot of people put out songs and then a year later, 2 years later, they're like, oh, I should have done that differently. I could have changed that. Now she has that chance after 11 years to go through and just tweak a couple of things and put it out as her own. Out to the garden to see. Keep quiet, cause we're dead if we knew, so close your eyes. Escape this town for a little while. Cause you were Romeo, I was a scarlet letter, and my daddy said stay away from Juliet. But you were everything to me, I was begging you please don't go. And I said, Romeo,
on the outskirts of town, and I said,
wow, she's doing so well with these higher notes. Outskirts sounded so good too, like, wow, wow.
When I met you on the outskirts of town, and I said, Romeo, save me, I've been feeling so alone. I keep waiting for you, but you never come.
The key change, I can't wait. As a producer, right, and as like a musician, and also as a massive Taylor Swift fan, in the fact that I was 8 when the song came out originally, you know, I grew up, whether it's in the car or in the living room or at a sleepover, every time the key change would hit and the beat would drop, I remember everybody would just rock out, and it would be like, that was the only beat drop. It felt like it was the only beat drop in music. That's what we grew up with. And oh, it's just perfect. I'm sorry. Percent perfect, everything about it. I don't even know how to explain it. Like, I don't know how people are processing this. Like, if you've seen other reactions that are better, you probably have. I'm sorry, I don't know what to say other than it's just so musically satisfying, you know, just, you know, making her with the slight changes, and she's adapting here and there, and she's changing a couple notes to better fit the song and the flow that she was, I think, initially going for. But she's got another decade of experience that she can put into it, and I doubt that this was rushed by the label or anything like that, right? When she made the first version, that was at the peak, you know, that was like, okay, you gotta just go. Now, I'm sure she's worked on this for a very long time, and she can make sure it's perfect and do it how she wants to do it, which I think is very important. She now has 100% creative control over what she does, and I'm really happy for her. I'm proud of her for, I mean, I love, I don't want to get into the, like, drama, but I'd love to be a fly on the wall in Scooter Braun's office today. Like, immediately, obviously, went on the trending page, big thing. Also, by the way, 100% guarantee this is going to get copyright claimed. So just subscribe. It'll make up for it. It's okay. Anyways, guys, I mean, that's basically it. Go listen to the song. Go blow it up. Make it bigger than the original. How crazy would that be? Part 6 of Olivia Rodrigo unreleased music coming out tomorrow. My reactions. You guys have been loving my reactions to those. Part 6 is tomorrow, so subscribe for that. Leave a like on the video if you enjoyed it. It motivates me to keep making stuff if I know that you guys are enjoying it. Comment below if you think this is better than the original. I love you, and I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy, fam. Peace out.